Good afternoon to all of you. Welcome. I'm Dr. Hayes Munch. I'm the director of bands here at Durham Harris College. We thank you for being here with us. We have hopefully a nice mixture of music for you today to share with you. That the piece you just heard was Roger Cichy's Fanfare for a Festive Day, and we thought that would be a nice concert opener to sort of rev up the energy and get us started here. The next piece, Vincent Persichetti's Divertimento. A little bit about Persichetti. He was an American composer and educator, and at the tender age of 32, he joined the faculty of a little-known place called the Juilliard School of Music, and was eventually became chair of the composition department there in 1963. And he basically composed throughout his career for every musical medium, with over 120 published works, and for the type of ensemble you see in front of you, the concert band, works like his Symphony No. 6 and this one have become sort of staples in the repertoire. The Divertimento was premiered by the Goldman Band back in 1950, and with the composer conducting. The composition was started during the previous summer, and in stories related to the sort of the genesis of the piece, Persichetti began writing the work with sort of this idea of a clash between the choirs of woodwinds and brass, with the timpani sort of arguing with them, so to speak. And after looking at it, he realized that the strings weren't going to be a part of this. And so, hence, we have one of the masterworks for the concert band, the Divertimento, in six movements, as your program indicates. And we will get started for you. Thanks again. This is Vincent Persichetti's Divertimento for Band.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much. The next piece we're going to do for you is called Medium Funk Prelude. It's by a gentleman named Paul Richards. And Mr. Richards is currently Associate Professor of Composition at the University of Florida. He previously taught at Baylor University and has received numerous awards for his compositions and has had commissions and works performed by some of the top performing ensembles and institutions like the University of Florida, Baylor, the University of Michigan, Nevada, Las Vegas, North Carolina, Greensboro, Northern Iowa, Syracuse, and Truman State. And a medium funk prelude is really a brief dance in which small groups of figures are sort of transformed and tossed about the ensemble. And the title comes from thumbing through what we call a jazz fake book, and it has basically all the changes of some of the jazz standards of the repertoire. And when they give these, for each piece, they'll give you a sort of a generic feeling of how the music should sound. So you might find things like slow swing or fast samba, or in this case, medium funk. So enjoy Paul Richards' Medium Funk Prelude.
Thank you.
Thank you. We're going to slow things down just a touch. The next piece that you're going to hear is the Abendlied of the Evening Song by Josef Rheinberger. He was a German organist and composer. And the stylistic influences of Rheinberger span from composers like Brahms to composers before that, Mendelssohn, Schumann, Robert Schumann, Franz Schubert, and going all the way back to J.S. Bach. So Rheinberger was a prolific composer with an output that ranged from religious works to operas, symphonies, chamber music, choral works, etc. And Rheinberger is also remembered for his elaborate and challenging organ compositions as well. The Evening Song was written in 1873 and is one of his best-known choral works. It sort of displays really this kind of exceptional lyric quality and utilizes the full range of dynamic contrast and volume. And the choral version includes the following text from the Bible verse Luke 24:29. It reads, "Bide with us, for evening shadows darken, and day will soon be over." Please enjoy Josef Rheinberger's Evening Song.
Thank you.
you so much. Carlos Surinach, composer next in our program, was among the 20th century's really premier composers for the dance. His works combine the fiery image of his native Spain, along with the technical sophistication of his German education. And he was educated at conservatories ranging from Barcelona to Berlin, as well as lecture seminars with the great Richard Strauss. Surinach taught at Carnegie Mellon University and received commissions and grants from the Louisville Orchestra, Ricordi, the Rothschild Foundation, the great dance choreographer Martha Graham, MGM Records, and among other many institutions. Rimangiando was Surinach's first ballet piece written in the U.S., and the three-movement work was at first a chamber work for trumpet, clarinet, and percussion, then followed his hit, and the composer did this on his own, made a version, a 20-minute version for orchestra, followed by the version you hear today for the concert band. And each movement is a dance in the flamenco tradition. The first movement, Belarius, is a quick and joyful piece with the unexpected humor of a practical joke. Followed by the second movement, the Saeta, is a mournful sung song in the streets of Seville on Good Friday. And the Garrotin is a fast, technical dance that accelerates into wild displays of emotion. So we hope you'll enjoy Carlos Surinach's Rimangiando.
Thank you.
Who wrote of Delibes' score, he says, "What charm, what wealth of melody. It brought me to shame, for I had known of this music. For if I had known of this music, I would never have written Swan Lake." And Delibes' ballet Sylvia was first produced at the Paris Opera in 1876. And the plot tells of Sylvia, a beautiful huntress, who was captured and abducted by Rhine, the huntsman. And Amyntas, who is in love with her, pursues her and her captor to a wooded area on the sea coast. And at this point, a festival is held to Bacchus. And this is the point in the ballet where you hear the march and procession of Bacchus. So again, thank you so much for being with us this afternoon and taking some time out of your busy schedules to join us. We appreciate appreciate you very much, and we hope to see you back at other Young Harris College Division of Fine Arts and Music Department events in the very near future. So again, the Young Harris College Concert Band, and this is Leo Delibes' March in Procession of Bacchus.
Thank you.
Thank you all so much. Safe travels, and we hope to see you again.